You have a headline in the Baltimore Sun, Mayor Catherine Pugh must resign. You came out and called for that pretty early on in this process. This is not just a Baltimore City issue. This is a state of Maryland issue, and it's the major city of the state facing this kind of pay-to-play situation, Comptroller.
Yeah, no, it's Baltimore is the beating heart of the state of Maryland, and I've come up here dozens and dozens, if not hundreds of times as a comptroller to champion what I view as a fabulous city with a lot of potential and great neighborhoods, tight-knit neighborhoods, good values, all sorts of potential. Sure, some problems, but a very resilient town that is the center of cultural and really historical assets for the state of Maryland. So the problem is that we have a tremendous crisis in confidence right now, and the mayor has to step aside. I'm sorry to be harsh, but she needs to resign yesterday. And the reason is that, you know, people are very busy with their own lives.
Right.
But if they don't trust their leaders to have competence and integrity, they lose trust in everything. It's a very corrosive aspect. So when you talk about an economic rebound here in Baltimore, they don't trust their leaders if they view them as lacking honesty and accountability. So you got to be able to do the little things. I'm thinking, you know, I disagreed with former Mayor William Donald Schaefer. I beat him.
I beat him in an election.
But there was a certain genius to William Donald Schaefer because he fixed the potholes. He picked up the trash. He got rid of the rats. He showed up on people's doorsteps. He communicated that he really cared about the city. Not only did he care, he had a great time championing the city. And people had some trust in his essential honesty and integrity. So when he had the big ideas of we're going to have public safety,
yep,
they went along with it.
Or we're going to have the inner harbor.
We're going to have the inner harbor, and we're going to redevelop the economy. Or we're going to improve the school system.
Right.
They don't just roll their eyes and say, oh, come on, that's never going to happen.
Right.
No. They say, hey, we have a certain amount of trust, so you earned our trust on the little things. We're going to give you some of our trust on the big things. And that's why it was so successful. And that's why I think we need a clean sweep up here in Baltimore. We need to bring in new people. I'm a huge fan of the new senator. What's her name? Mary Washington.
You endorsed her.
You know, I have no idea if she ever wants to be mayor or even thought about it. But there's a person who is a good person, who is in politics for the right reason. If I sat down with her and talked about 12 issues, I might disagree with her on six of them.
All right.
That's okay.
Right.
Because she has a basic goodness to
right.
her. That's what Baltimore needs. And if they I fully believe they will get it in the next election. But we need to take action right now.
Right now, Comptroller Franchot, it's been discovered based on our city charter and everything, there's no process in place for to remove a mayor. Some cities have a recall process, other things. I talked with Andy Green from the Baltimore Sun, and you're not a legislator anymore, but one of the things we were talking about is we need a process so that conviction shouldn't be the only, that's a very low bar to have with a public official. We impeach governors. We've had a state senator expelled who wasn't charged with a crime. There have been different ways to get rid of somebody. I believe that needs to be for mayors, too, that we shouldn't just wait on a conviction, that should be the standard for somebody who's doing something unethical.
Let me just applaud Governor Hogan for referring this matter to the state prosecutor, because obviously laws have been broken. But the state prosecutor, as you know, takes a long time. So who knows what the process
is. It'll be a year or so.
Yeah. But if the mayor thinks that she is going to stay in office.
That's what she said. Now.
Yeah. I cannot imagine her being there without indictments being lodged against her. And what an embarrassment, further embarrassment
that
is for the city. So why not step aside gracefully and allow the city to address this crisis in confidence? And Jack Young, I talked to him last, you know, he seemed to be stabilizing force. Let the city have a certain calmness before the next election. Next election, everyone's got to get involved. We can't have this low voter turnout. We can't have people turning around and rolling their eyes and saying, oh, we don't want to get involved. You got to get involved. If you live in Baltimore, these next elections coming up are crucial. We need a clean sweep. And people that coming in should not be part of the political machine.
What's interesting, Comptroller Franchot, and this is kind of buried in the headline of the legislature passing the new Curran Commission funding bill. I understand it's going to be close to $855 million over the next 2 years. They're going to be spent towards the goal of $4 billion in the next 10 years. But hidden in what the legislature passed was something called an inspector general component that will be in there, something that the governor called for. You've talked about how the dollars are being spent. I believe that we do need to monitor all this new spending money and how it's spent, including maybe the issue of air conditioners in schools that you've been championing for a few years, for the last few years now.
Yeah, no, it's. I come back to the point. Look, Mayor Pugh, people forget, was the majority leader of the state Senate in Annapolis. That Annapolis machine and the Baltimore machine, such as it is, and it's disassembling right in front of our eyes. We need to get new leaders in who are in politics for the right reason, not to line their pockets and grease their palms and have some kind of bribery system set up. We need politicians that are actually honest and competent and have integrity. I had 1,000 disagreements with William Donald Schaefer, but, you know, the guy was competent and he had integrity.
If the schools had air conditioners, he would have gotten them. Exactly.
And he would have been out there and installing them himself. And he also had a good time doing it. You know, he didn't like,
It was joyful.
He was a joyful champion. We can get new leaders like that in Baltimore. If you look at people like Mary Washington or look at other people that are in politics now, they're there. But we need a much more active citizen involvement by the people that live here in Baltimore.
And I'm going to say again, when it comes to education dollars, Comptroller, because it's very important, some of the issues will come in front of your board, the Board of Public Works, to have an oversight vehicle, to have some other eyes, to me, are very important. We have a brand new spending scheme, spending plan like Curwin, that we monitor how these dollars are spent. Because a lot of people have lost trust that the dollars are being spent appropriately.
Yeah, there's a lot of new Curwin money coming to Baltimore. Who in their right mind would trust that it's going to be properly spent? So, yes, you're right as far as the inspector general, but it doesn't really I'm sure we have some kind of inspector general right now in the city of Baltimore.
We do.
Yeah. Well, how? Hi.
We do.
Hello, guys.
But like you say, this would be at the state level, and this would not fall under the control of the city, which to me is a more important component. And, Comptroller, if you can, just talk about, because a lot of people don't understand, the Board of Public Works, when you, the governor, and the treasurer sit there, the things you decide on in terms of spending proposals and the rest of that, there has to be a check and balance. We can't just be writing checks to people without the appropriate oversight at the panel you saw. The Board of Public Works.
I'm more concerned with the fact that, and I hate to have your listeners think I'm in some kind of conspiratorial mind. I'm not. I've been in politics for a long time. I understand what the Annapolis political machine is. It's not just the former speaker and the current Senate president. It's there are dozens and dozens of senior staff people that now work for really toxic special interests and are still there in Annapolis earning money to do the wrong things. Up here in Baltimore, you have a smaller version of that. It's the Baltimore machine.
Pay to play.
And you got to get through to the voters and say, A, you need to turn out. B, you need to be energized. C, you need to support candidates that are not part of these machines because otherwise we're never going to regain the trust and confidence of the citizens up here. And if we do that, we're going to see the kind of big ideas, the economic renaissance of Baltimore, such a great town, got so many great things going for it. The education system you mentioned with the Curwin division and all that, and I totally support what you're saying about independent accountability. But when you get these big ideas, public safety, I mean, how can you communicate to the citizens of Baltimore City that the police force is a positive, you know, necessity to that we have to have public safety right. in order to have an economy. If they just don't trust you to pick the trash up.
Right, or fix potholes in the street.
I mean, in my agency, on a very small level, I demand that my employees answer the damn phone.
That's right.
That is, and I'm not talking 30 minutes after ringing. I'm talking about 1 minute, 40 seconds, live, friendly,
customer
professional
service.
Employee. Get on the phone and respect the taxpayer, respond to the taxpayer, get results for the taxpayer. Same thing in Baltimore City. We need a competent, honest government.